In this lecture, we will discuss the quadratic equation. First of all, we will go through the introduction and the significance of quadratic equation. Introduction means the equation that is called the quadratic equation. After that, we will learn to find the solutions of the quadratic equation. Solution implies to that value of the variable which satisfies the given quadratic equation. There are three methods to find the solution of the quadratic equation. First is by factorization. In this method, we make vectors of the given equation to find the solution. Second method is by completing the squares. In this method, we complete the squares of the equation to find the solution. And the third one is to find the solution of the quadratic equation by using the standard quadratic formula. All the methods will be discussed in the detail. First of all, let's go through the introduction. Any equation that can be written in the form of ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0 is called a quadratic equation. The condition here is that the a should never be equal to 0. Because if a becomes equal to 0, then our equation is no more a quadratic equation. Rather, it will become a linear equation. The word quadratic is derived from the Latin word quadratus, which means square or two. The maximum power of variable in quadratic equation is 2. And we know that the maximum power of variable in any equation is called the degree of that equation. So the degree of quadratic equation is 2. Thus, all the second degree equations are called quadratic equations. The general form of quadratic equation is given by ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. The first term in the equation is called quadratic term. The second term is called the linear term. And the third one is called a constant. By now, you must be wondering what is the significance of studying these quadratic equations. Let's consider that we are given a problem in which we are given to find two numbers whose sum is equal to 10 and their product is equal to 21. Here we have to find those two numbers who give us the sum equal to 10 and the product equal to 21. Now let's suppose that the first number is x, then the second number will be 10 minus x. Because the sum of two must be equal to 10. As we know that the product of these two numbers is equal to 21, so we write it as x into 10 minus x is equal to 21. If we multiply these two, we get 10x minus x square is equal to 21. Now if we simplify this equation, we get x square minus 10x plus 21 is equal to 0. Thus, this becomes a quadratic equation. Now, the solution of this equation will give us those two values of x that will satisfy the given quadratic equation and the conditions that the sum must be equal to the 10 and their product must be equal to 21. Quadratic equation is also used in manufacturing. The figure here shows a dish antenna. This antenna is designed using the quadratic equation. Another interesting example is suspension bridge, the basis of whose design is also quadratic equation. An important application of quadratic equation is well-known Pythagoras theorem. The Pythagorean theorem states that for any right-angled triangle, hypotenuse square is equal to perpendicular square plus base square. It should be noted that this Pythagoras theorem is only valid for right angled triangles. This theorem is also solved using the quadratic equation. Now let's move towards the solution of the quadratic equation, meaning that we have to find that value of the variable which satisfies the given quadratic equation. The general form of quadratic equation is ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. We have to find that value of x which is when substituted in the above equation gives 0 as a result. The number of values that satisfy an equation is always equal to the degree of that equation. Quadratic equation is a second degree equation, so there will be two values of x that will satisfy this given equation. These values of the variable or x are called the roots of the equation, and they are written in the form of a solution set. Solution set is denoted by SS. SS is equal to curly brackets first value, comma second value, and then curly brackets close. Now let's discuss the methods of solving quadratic equation. First method is by factorization. In this method, we make the factors of the equation to find its solution. For example, we are given an equation x square plus 5x plus 6 is equal to 0. And we have to solve it by factorization. The first step is to divide the linear term 5x into two such terms so that when these two terms are added up, they give 5x. And when we multiply them, the result is 6x squared. So we divide 5x into 2x and 3x. When we sum these two, it gives us 5x. And if we multiply these two, it results into 6x square. So let's rewrite the equation in the form of the factors. X square plus 2x plus 3x plus 6x is equal to 0. down, the next step is that we will take some factor common out of the first two terms and another factor common out of the last two terms. Taking x common from the first two terms, we get x common into x plus 2. And taking 3 common from the next two terms, we get 3 into x plus 2. So the equation that we get is equal to x into x plus 2 plus 3 into x plus 2. Now taking x plus 2 from the equation, so we get x plus 2 into x plus 3 is equal to 0. Now there is a way of solving this equation that either x plus 2 is equal to 0 or x plus 3 is equal to 0. If x plus 2 is equal to 0, so we get x is equal to minus 2. Taking 2 on the other side gives us x is equal to minus 2. And if x plus 3 is equal to 0, we get x is equal to minus 3. Here we get two values of x, that is minus 2 and minus 3. Writing it as a solution set, SS is equal to minus 2 and minus 3. The equation that we had was x square plus 5x plus 6 is equal to 0. The roots that we found are minus 2 and minus 3. If any one of these two roots is substituted back in the original equation, it will satisfy the equation. Let's try it with minus 2. So we get minus 2 square plus 5 into minus 2 plus 6 is equal to 0. So 4 minus 10 plus 6 is equal to 0. 4 plus 6 is equal to 10 minus 10 is equal to 0. So we see that this equation is satisfied by the minus 2, which is the root of this equation. Similarly, you can try it out with minus 3. It will also satisfy this equation. We can also check our answer using this quadratic equation calculator. The equation that we have was x square plus 5x plus 6 is equal to 0. The roots are the minus 2 and minus 3. If we look at the graph of the given equation, we see that the graph crosses the x-axis at minus 2 and minus 3. These are the two values that satisfy the given equation, or these are the two roots of the equation. The graph will cross the y-axis at that value at which the x becomes equal to 0. So when we put x is equal to 0, we get 6. So we see that the graph crosses the y-axis at 6. The graph of a quadratic equation is always a parabola. Now let's take another example to make it more clear. So the equation we have now is x square minus 6x plus 8 is equal to 0. If we try to solve this equation by factorization, we will repeat the same first step, that is to factorize the 6x into two such factors whose sum result into 6x and the product is 8x square. Now we factorize 6x into minus 4x and minus 2x. When these two are added, they give minus 6x and their product is 8x square. We put these factors of 6x into the actual equation instead of 6x. It becomes x square minus 4x minus 2x plus 8 is equal to 0. Now we will take the x square common from the first two terms and 2 common out from the next two terms. So we get x into x minus 4 minus 2 into x minus 4. Now taking x minus 4 common from the this equation, so we get x minus 4 into x minus 2 is equal to 0. Now either x minus 4 is equal to 0 or x minus 2 is equal to 0. If x minus 4 is equal to 0, then x is equal to 4, and if x minus 2 is equal to 0, then x is equal to 2. Now the two values that we get are 4 and 2. So the solution set are 4 and 2. These are the roots of the given equation. In this lecture, we have gone through the complete introduction and the significance of studying the quadratic equation. And then we discussed the solution of the quadratic equation and the methods of finding the quadratic equation. In solution, we have to find that value of the variable that satisfies the given quadratic equation. There are three methods for finding the solution of the quadratic equation. In this lecture, we have discussed only the first method, which is finding the solution of the quadratic equation by factorization. In the next lecture, we will discuss the other two methods to solve the quadratic equation. These two methods are by completing squares, in which we try to complete the squares of the equation to find the solution. And the other one is by quadratic formula, in which we use the quadratic formula to find the solution.